Joe just had hot pudding. And trust me, I've been to my father's house for dinner and had hot pudding a few times. That's right. So a little bit of the risotto, and then I like to put in just like a little bit extra oil, because you want to like toast the rice. The rice has a lot of flavor, so if you put a little bit more oil in it and start to toast the rice, you get some really big flavor. So we stock eating risotto. I'm making mushroom risotto, so I'm using a mushroom stock. If you don't like mushrooms, you need chicken stock, veg stock, only use water. This stuff is nuts. It's porcini mushroom stock. Imagine if you just took a bunch of mushrooms, stuffed it into a grenade, pulled the pin, and threw it. Boom! That's mushroom stock. So the risotto is in two parts. So this is the first part. I do that stock. I like to just switch it around, and you want to let it cook out. There's a lot of starch in the rice, and as you cook it out, the rice drinks out the broth and releases some of the starch. So that's kind of the first part. Cook it, cook it, cook it, and you want to get that rice to about 80% cooked. So put the stock in, work it around, work it around. And you can do this like for a dinner party. You know, do that first step, then go 80% cooked, you put it in the fridge, try to forget about it, and then day two, or when your guests come, you do the second part. So we're kind of going to mirror what we did in the beginning. So again, a little bit more of the onions and garlic. Yeah, so when the rice is about 80% cooked, it looks like this. So after you put like the stock in it, and you cook it, and you cook it, and you taste it, it should look like that. It looks a little bit nutty and crunchy, and that's perfect. You want to add about 80%. And so just to like bring it back to life a little bit, onions and garlic, again, a little pinch of salt, a little twist of pepper. If you're cooking at home, you're like, ah, this doesn't taste right. Pinch of salt. It's going to heighten the natural flavor of anything. And so we go in with the rice that's about 80% cooked. You can see that? Go ahead. Put that in and then top pan. And then it's all about just like bringing it back to life. So get it mixed in with the onions and garlic and then a little bit more of the porcini broth. Oh man, it smells so good. Cool, and then as that heats up, there's like one way to finish with risotto, and that's cheese, butter, parsley, and lemon. The butter kind of makes it super nice and creamy, along with like, some of the Parmesan cheese. It kind of creates this like fruity deliciousness. So a little bit of Parmesan cheese and butter. And when you cook this all out, so the risotto is like really big and full and mushroomy, you want to kind of cut through that a little bit. And lemon is kind of perfect for the job. It just rounds out the whole dish and gives like a little bite to it. It's absolutely delicious. And then I just finish with some light herbs. You can use tarragon, but I use parsley. I find it's like, it just has enough fragrance for the mushroom. And you just kind of mix it around till the butter and the cheese is kind of melted. And all of a sudden, you start seeing this beautiful consistency. You can see how creamy it is. Oh my God. And the cheese on it, that's delicious. I just wanted to share with you the mushroom risotto. And the best thing is you get